Hello, I'm Amara Jones, and welcome to Kathy TV, your daily video news brief, here to take you to three headline numbers in just 3 minutes, giving you a different take on everything from housing policy to the Real Housewives. Well, this is our first day back after our holiday hiatus, and I'm still reeling from the premiere of Downton Abbey last night with its fires and affairs and everything. The first number up today is 49. That's the age of Stuart Scott, the ESPN reporter who died yesterday after nearly a 10-year battle with cancer, best well known for his time in the lead chair in SportsCenter. He also produced countless specials and conducted countless interviews during his more than two decades at the network. He was loved by fans and colleagues and players alike. His ability to blend high-end sports analysis with the swagger of the locker room, producing a number of memorable phrases that always made a larger point. But perhaps his most shining moment, even by his own admission, would be his nearly 8 years that he spent battling cancer with a grit, a grace, and determination that were just downright inspirational. As the New York Times points out, he accepted an ESPY award for perseverance over the summer, even though he'd had four surgeries in the 7 days that preceded that ceremony. Now, his most beloved sport, by his own admission, was football. He said that he loved football as much as he did his own two kids, but at a time in which his beloved sport has shown the exact opposite of the qualities that he displayed while battling cancer and throughout his entire life, his example is something that we can all learn from. As he might have said, he must have been a bus driver because he took us all to school. The next number up today is 28,000. That's the number of people who attended the funeral of New York City police officer Wen Jin Liu, one of two police officers gunned down in that tragic NYPD shooting that we spoke about a couple of weeks ago, making his funeral one of the largest police funerals in the history of New York City. Now, what was shocking is that at his funeral, thousands of police officers turned their back on New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio when he rose to give his remarks, even after they were asked to not do so by the New York City Police Commissioner Bill Bratton. He said that this event of grief shouldn't be turned into one of grievance. He had to do that because at the first funeral for Rafael Ramos, who was gunned down in that same shooting, they'd done the same. Now, what's interesting is that for weeks, police officers and their unions have been saying that protesters and the public are wrong, that they're not cowboys with a devil-may-care attitude while walking the beat and patrolling streets. But when you turn your back on your democratically elected boss who signs your check, you're actually making the protesters' point. The last number up today is $2 million, as in $2 million. That's how much the movie Selma has made since its Christmas Day premiere in over 22 theaters across the country. $2 million from 22 theaters is not too shabby, and in that time, it's gained a lot of critical acclaim and also garnered a number of award nominations such as the Golden Globes. But in the past couple of days, the movie's executive producer, Oprah Winfrey, while out promoting the movie, stepped in it and since then has been trying to clean it up off of her shoe. In an interview with People Magazine on New Year's Day, she said that the Black Lives Matter protests were good, but that they lack a leader and lacked a clear set of demands, and that her movie shows that without a leader and without a clear set of demands, you can't be successful. Now, what's interesting is that her movie kind of doesn't show that. I mean, one of the points is that Dr. Martin Luther King was chosen by activists as much as he chose himself. And in so many other ways on this, she's wrong, which is kind of just a new thing for Oprah. As a matter of fact, the Millions March NYC, in which 50,000 people turned out on the streets in New York City, was organized and led by 19-year-old Amara Elliott and 23-year-old Sinead Nichols. And they have a clear set of demands on their website. And Justice League NYC on their website also involved has a list of 10 clear demands. And Million Hoodies has one clear demand on their website, which is an end to police militarization. And so on this, Oprah Winfrey, who's right about so many things, actually took a wrong turn.